On July 29th, 2021, a magnitude 8.2 earthquake struck Alaska. It was the strongest earthquake felt in the United States since 1965. A magnitude 7.1 earthquake struck California in 2019. It was the strongest earthquake California has felt in about 20 years. Mount Fuji, the tallest peak in Japan and one of the largest volcanoes in the world, is located right next to the most populated city in the world, Tokyo. Mount St. Helens, located along the western coast of the United States, famously erupted in 1980. It was one of the most devastating volcanic eruptions ever recorded in human history. About 20,000 earthquakes occur each year, and there are about 1,500 potentially active volcanoes around the world, not including the continuous belts of volcanoes along the ocean floor at mid-ocean ridges. What do all these devastating natural disasters have in common? And how are they predictable? Stick around to find out. Even though when an earthquake or a volcanic eruption will occur is not predictable, where they are more likely to occur is. It may seem like earthquakes and volcanoes occur randomly around the world, but if you begin to map out the location of earthquakes and volcanoes around the world, you start to see a pattern. This pattern is, in fact, the location of plate boundaries where Earth's crust is actively interacting. Plate boundaries are where large sheets of Earth's crust are colliding, sliding, or dividing with one another. As you can imagine, these interactions can create tremendous earthquakes, volcanoes, and also some of the most incredible landforms on the planet. One interesting series of plate boundaries in particular is this horseshoe-shaped belt of earthquakes and volcanoes found around the Pacific Ocean. This region of concentrated geologic activity includes the western part of the United States, such as California, Alaska, Japan, Indonesia, and much more. All places well known to be prone to natural disasters. Interestingly, this area of the Pacific is responsible for approximately 77% of all volcanic eruptions and 86% of the largest volcanoes currently known to man. And it's also responsible for 69% of all earthquakes with a magnitude of 5 and higher, and 100% of all earthquakes greater than a magnitude of 8. Because the horseshoe of fire doesn't sound very cool, this region of the world is known as the Pacific Ring of Fire. Along divergent boundaries like the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, earthquakes are common, but only in a narrow area close to the ridge, and consistently at less than 18.5 miles deep, which is not considered very deep at all. Shallow earthquakes are also common along transform faults, such as the San Andreas Fault in California. Along subduction zones at convergent boundaries, however, earthquakes are very abundant, and they are increasingly deep on the landward side of the subduction zone, as one enormous tectonic plate is being pushed under another to be remelted back into Earth's mantle. The interaction along plate boundaries appears to result in an increase in the frequency of earthquakes at these locations, including the Pacific Ring of Fire. Stronger earthquakes are more likely to occur along active plate boundaries and are more common at transform and convergent plate boundaries where pressure can build up between plates. Earthquakes typically occur along plate boundaries. Volcanoes are found at divergent boundaries where plates move apart, allowing magma to upwell between plates at rift zones, creating new crust, typically along the ocean floor. Volcanoes also occur at convergent plate boundaries where subducting oceanic crust is melted back into Earth's interior. This less dense melted magma can rise back through the crust, to form incredible volcanic arcs and volcanic island arcs all over the planet. The interaction that occurs along plate boundaries results in an increased number of volcanic activity at these locations. Because volcanoes tend to occur at divergent and convergent plate boundaries, such as the active plate boundaries in the Ring of Fire, are earthquakes and volcanoes really random? Most volcanoes occur along plate boundaries. Let's take a look at a map of the world's most recent volcanoes. Notice many of them occur in lines called arcs all around the world. Let's take a look at a map of the most recent earthquakes. Do you notice a similar pattern with volcanoes? Now, let's take a close look at the location of some plate boundaries around the world.
Aha! Yes! Eureka! I got it! Solution! Answer! Clarity!
But wait, what about Hawaii? Mauna Loa is the most active volcano in the world! It is a shield volcano that towers nearly 14,000 feet high. This enormous volcano covers half of the Big Island of Hawaii, and by itself amounts to about 85% of the area of all the other Hawaiian islands combined. But it's located right smack in the middle of the Pacific Plate. Turns out, Hawaii is what scientists call a hotspot. And I'm not talking about a hotspot saving you some data on your phone plan. Hawaii is a volcanic hotspot. A volcanic hotspot is an area in the Earth's mantle where heat rises in what is called a thermal plume. Higher heat and lower pressure at the base of the crust melts the rock and forms additional magma. This magma can then rise through the cracks in the lithosphere, or the crust, and erupt to form some of the most spectacular volcanoes, like Mauna Loa. Interestingly, as tectonic plates continue to move over the hotspot, older volcanoes break away and move along with the tectonic plate. This allows newer volcanoes to form in their place. Plate tectonic movement over a hotspot can result in long chains of volcanoes like the Hawaiian Islands, which includes up to 132 islands, reefs, shallow banks, shoals, and seamounts stretching over 1,500 miles. At first, Hawaii completely undermined the theory of plate tectonics. Until the hotspot theory was proposed, seemingly random volcanoes such as the Hawaiian Islands seemed impossible to explain according to the theory of plate tectonics, since they occurred nowhere near a plate boundary. From 1994 to 1998, scientists mapped the islands of Hawaii in detail, and what they found was amazing. One of the most extraordinary things these scientists were able to prove was that the age of the Hawaiian Islands corresponded directly with their positions. The oldest Hawaiian island of Kauai is approximately 5.1 million years old, and the Big Island of Hawaii is less than a half a million years old, and new lava flows are consistently adding brand new land. Scientists now theorize that the hotspot remains relatively stationary. While the Pacific Plate moves in a northwesterly direction at a rate of approximately 2 to 4 inches a year, the Pacific Plate movement carries the volcanic islands away from the hotspot, making them dormant. Meanwhile, new active volcanoes form at the hotspot, which today is underneath the Big Island of Hawaii. Volcanic hotspot chains such as Hawaii now provide a perfect window into the motions of tectonic plates and provide even more support for the theory of plate tectonics today.
Hey guys, it's me, Little E. It's time for a new joke. What did one volcano say to the other? I lava you!
Although the exact timing of when an earthquake or volcanic eruption is not predictable, the location of these geologic activities are. The vast majority of earthquakes and volcanoes occur along plate boundaries around the world, and the largest earthquakes and volcanoes typically occur in the Pacific Ring of Fire.
Went down, 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 and the flames went higher. and it burns, burns, burns.